Hello, machinist. I'm Hiroyuki Furatani from the Sales Promotion Department.
Hello, I'm Yukiko Watanabe from International Sales Department. So, Furatani-san, I have a question for you.
Okay.
Yep. So, I've got a question from a customer, and he said, I want to install a multitasking machine for automation, but I want to know how to unload the finished work pieces.
I see.
I know there are many ways to unload the work pieces, but I'm wondering if you could tell me what methods are available and when you recommend them.
I see, I understand. Yes, yeah, a sample work piece machine or multitasking race, especially these will be from bar material, small and short one, and long shaft works. There are many ways to unload.
Yep.
So let's start with the easy one first.
Yes.
Okay?
Yep.
Please come here.
Okay.
Hi, Watanabe-san. This is the first one.
Oh, I know. This is a part catcher.
Oh, correct. This is Nakamura Tenai called part catcher A. This bucket is used to unload the finished work pieces and the remnant materials. The bucket moved forward like this, take the work piece and drop into the box, moving like that. Okay, then and the conveyor inside the
bucket. Conveyor.
Yeah.
Yep. And the material goes to like this.
Here.
Yep. Okay.
This component here.
A very easy system. So what do you do, drop a work piece into the bucket?
Yes, generally it uses an injection device that puts the workpiece out inside of the chuck. There are many ways to push it out, such as a simple blowing with air, using a spring hose and air cylinder, so on.
So it's up to the customer's specifications, right?
That's right.
Okay.
Another way is to attach the bucket to the turret. I guess you could call it a turret parts catcher. Please take a look at the video for a moment. With the bucket attached on the turret, this is a video of the remnant material unloading. The remnant material is dropped to the bucket and moved into the workpiece box.
So I like it can be moved.
That's right. This one can go and unload it by itself. Well, I have the next one to show you. Please come with me.
Okay.
Watanabe-san.
Hey.
This is a device called Path Catcher G.
Path Catcher G.
G means G for gripper. The finished workpiece is gripped by the gripper and moved into the conveyor inside the machine for unloading. The gripper clamps the workpiece. So there's no need for extra device to push it out.
Oh, that's fine. It is cramped by a plastic hand, so the workpiece does not seem to be scratched.
That's right. Good. Let me show you how it actually works. Okay, moving. The gripper hand cramps the finished workpiece and take it to the conveyor inside the machine.
Okay.
Like this. Now the fish workpiece comes out from here.
It's coming.
It's coming?
Oh, perfect.
Perfect.
Yep.
Well, Watanabe-san, I have some other interesting thing to show you. Please come with me.
Okay. Yeah, let's go.
This machine is called NTJ100.
Yes.
See the turret swinging to the left and right.
It's a really unique machine.
Thanks. We attach the gripper to this upper turret to clamp and unload the finished workpiece. Also, the remnant material can be unloaded by same gripper.
Okay.
The gripper is opened and closed using a milling servo motor.
Oh, that's wonderful. So it's really smart to use servo motors.
Yes, I think so. The good thing is that when gripping, the load of the servo motor can be used to check if the workpiece is in position. Also, the gripper force can be commanded in the program.
Oh, so it prevents empty gripping and can also gently grip thin work pieces, right?
That's right.
Okay.
Let me show you how it actually works.
Okay.
The gripper hands grab the finished component.
Yes.
And take it to the conveyor inside the machine.
Mm-hmm.
It's coming soon.
Coming. Oh.
Stop.
Oh, perfect.
Of course, Watanabe-san.
Yep.
The same thing can be done with tool spindle machine as well as the turret machine.
Mm.
Some of our customers use it to pick up work pieces with complex shapes.
Okay. So, Kuratani-san, so how do you unload long work pieces like shaft bars here?
There is a device called the shaft unloader.
Mm-hmm.
This device unloads shaft work piece from behind the spindle. The general flow is loading bar material into the spindle and unloading from the opposite spindle. Actually, we have a simple device.
Mm-hmm.
We call it the Tokoroten system.
Tokoroten. What is Tokoroten?
There's a Japanese food called Tokoroten. Do you know it?
Yes, I know the food, of course.
I eat it a lot in the summer.
Yep.
Please see this video. There's a fixed pipe inside the spindle through which the finished parts are ejected.
Mm-hmm.
We say Tokoroten. Because the finished parts push out the finished parts in the pipe. It is very simple system.
Wow, there are really a lot of ways to unload work pieces.
There are other ways to use a gantry loader or a robot for unloading, but we'll save that for next time.
Next time. Okay, so I guess we are still in the middle of the world.
It will never end.
Okay. So, okay, I'm looking forward to the next time. So, thank you very much for teaching me about the various methods of unloading the birds today. So, now I'm confident to answer the questions from our customers.
Good luck! And make good proposal to your customers.
Okay, thank you very much. So, yes, so I will do my best. Okay, that's all for today. So if you like this video, please give us a high rating and subscribe to our channel. So thank you for watching. See you, machinists. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye now.